Alrighty, welcome to Runion Rings Entertainment Trivia Night. Tonight is season 1, episode 7, and we've got High and Mighty, whose current record is 1-1, against the Rawdoggers, who are also 1-1. On the High and Mighty team, we've got Josh Connolly as the captain, Lance Runion, and Scott MacArthur. And then we've also, on the Rawdoggers, we have Allison Connolly, captain, and Noah Sheffield and Izzy Velez. Y'all go around and say where you're at right now. You want to start with High and Mighty. Josh, you want to start us off?
Syracuse, New York.
Same. Both of us.
Sunny San Diego.
You don't.
Lucky. Yeah, get out of here.
From Murfreesboro, Tennessee.
There you go.
Yeah, like
Syracuse, New York.
Four of us here in Syracuse right now.
Woo!
Oh. Izzy, did you say where you were?
Yeah, Syracuse.
And Noah, you're in Syracuse too?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Woo. All right, well, I'm coming from Nashville, Tennessee. Hope everybody has their drink. I know I've got mine.
Let's go.
Apparently, I am the VP of this franchise, so...
Whoa, here. When did... There was not a vote.
I don't know. I just saw one day, and I was like, I'll take it.
Fair enough.
I mean, that's nepotism at its finest.
All right, I'm going to read through these rules. I'm sure y'all know them. If y'all have any questions, you just can either stop me, or we can talk about it after I'm done. All right, there are 12 rounds of the trivia. There'll be 24 questions total. Round 6 is going to be head-to-head, which is worth double points. And the final round will be the niche category, which is also going to be worth double points. You've got 30 seconds to answer. Teams will designate a final answer person and repeat the answer. So we'll just have that be Josh and Allison, the captains. If answering wrong, the opposing team gets a chance to steal 15 seconds to answer and 1 point for stealing correctly. Unless it's a niche category or a double down has been used, then the team that stole can get 2 points. Each lifeline can be used once per show. You've got phone a friend, surrender, and double down. You cannot pair up lifelines. No lifelines can be used in the bonus round, which is head-to-head or the niche round. Surrender and double down must be used when the category is read aloud. I'll try and ask y'all as I'm reading it if y'all want to use them. Phone a friend can be anyone as long as they didn't help write the question. So, and I did these by myself with a little help at the end, but no one that y'all would know. Well, maybe Lance, but you can't. I'll tell you if you can't phone them. If you phone a friend and they answer, the team has a new timer of 30 seconds to read the question. If the phone a friend does not answer, then you'll have your original timer resumed. Surrender allows you to answer incorrectly and not give the opposing team the chance to steal. Double down gives you 2 points for the correct answer. If wrong, the other team gets 2 points if answered correctly on the steal. And those must be said before the question's read. The niche round, members of each team have picked their favorite category for trivia beforehand. The opposing team chose one of those three categories for the other team to answer. Head-to-head, each team will have 20 seconds to give an answer. First team, we're actually going to do first team to three on this one, is going to be awarded that. Video chat must be on. If your chat goes out, you are not allowed to answer the round's question at hand. Your team will be sent the categories 30 minutes before the match starts. I did not do that. Is that new?
It's okay.
I'm no. Sorry. I thought that was the niche part. New rule, if you are talking or interrupt the opposing team while they're answering, you will lose your chance to steal. Sound good?
Josh, let's you're go. Muted. Josh, right. You're on mute.
So to thank start out, so to figure out who's going to go first, I have written a number on a slip of paper between 1... and we'll say 50. Whoever's closest can go first or choose the order they go.
Pick it.
Allison, you mean 15?
Yes.
Okay.
37.
Yeah, do 37.
37? The answer was 42.
Nice.
So, Josh, you get to pick if y'all want to go first or second.
Second?
Okay. And then Rawdoggers, y'all will go first. Okay. Let me get my little buzzer out and timer. All right, y'all's first category is going to be Super Bowl super fans. And this will be for the Rawdoggers. All right. Do you want to use any lifelines before we get started?
No.
We're good.
All right. What song was being sung during the Super Bowl when Janet Jackson's breast was exposed in 2004?
Oh, my gosh.
Huh?
Her boobs?
It was.
I think I remember that.
Justin Timberlake. Were they singing a Justin Timberlake song?
Was it? Oh. I mean, I don't remember any boobs.
10 seconds. I can't think of a freaking Justin Timberlake song.
All right, need an answer.
Cry Me a River, finalist.
That sounds great.
That's not it.
That is incorrect. High and Mighty, you've got 15 seconds. What song was being sung during the Super Bowl when Janet Jackson's breast was exposed in 2004?
Tell me you know the name of it, Josh.
I don't know, but yeah, I mean.
Okay.
I don't know what she did with Justin Timberlake ever, but.
I know it was something like, I'm going to take my clothes off. It's not Sexy Back, but that's the only thing that's coming to my head.
Sexy Back, Justin Timberlake.
That ain't it.
That's incorrect.
Dang it.
The answer was Rock Your Body.
That's it.
Rock Your Body.
Hey, you guys remember something from 2014?
I remember
early
that.
Game
I was
jitters.
By that.
Well, I saw that.
All right. High and Mighty, y'all's question. Name the 6 music artists that performed during the 2022 Super Bowl.
All right. Eminem, 50 Cent,
Dr. Dre.
What's her name?
Snoop Dogg.
Snoop Dogg.
What's that chick's name?
Who?
What chick?
When there was like a big woman.
5 seconds.
Megan Thee Stallion?
No.
Ludacris.
I don't know.
I only got to 4 anyways. I don't know.
All right. Rawdoggers, name the 6 music artists that performed during the 2022 Super Bowl.
Okay, he said...
Mary J. Blige.
Kendrick.
Kendrick Lamar. Snoop Dogg.
Eminem.
50 Cent.
50 Cent.
Give me an answer.
Did he say big girl? Lizzo? I'm thinking Lizzo.
No, it's not another girl. It's another guy.
Dr. Dre.
Oh,
no. Yeah, how did y'all not know who I was talking about?
Sorry, that was kind of a long-answered one. All right, moving on to round 2. Score is 0-0, and the category is App Store. Anybody want to use any of their lifelines? Nope. Okay. Nope. So, Rawdoggers. What is the most downloaded app globally of 2021?
2021.
TikTok, maybe?
Probably.
Yeah, I would probably think guess. TikTok.
That's a great guess. You want to go with that?
I like that guess, actually. I like it.
TikTok, final answer.
That's right. Good job. All right. High and Mighty. What is the most used gambling site in the United States?
DraftKings?
Either DraftKings or FanDuel.
I think DraftKings is over FanDuel.
I would think.
Yeah. I feel like it was more popular first, so maybe.
Yeah. Maybe it's, DraftKings.
Let's do DraftKings final. All
right. We're going FanDuel.
Yeah, let's go FanDuel.
Yeah, let's do that.
FanDuel?
Yeah.
Oh, nuts.
I don't think so.
It's actually, it's Bovada.
Oh, damn.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I guess that haven't heard of worldwide. I mean.
All right. End of round two, we've got Rawdoggers up 1-0. Start of round three, the category is games. Any lifelines for this? Double down or surrender? Nope.
Nope.
All right. Rawdoggers. In Scrabble, how many points is the letter V worth? V as in victory.
I want to say they're like 4 or 6.
I've never played Scrabble.
I think it might be 4.
Okay, let's go with 4, final answer.
That's correct!
Nice.
Okay, high and mighty. Your question is, how many pieces are played on a full chess set?
Well, that's one side, right? Or is it both sides?
Is it total both sides or one side?
How many pieces are played with a total full chess set?
32. 16 and 16 is 32.
Wait,
it's 18. It's gotta be. It's 36.
Need an answer. 5 seconds.
2 rooks, 2 knights, 2 bishops.
Give an answer.
Queen,
it's pong, 32 pong, final. Pong. No, there's only 8. There's only 8 rows. There's not 9 rows.
That was close.
Yeah, 32. You got 2 rooks, 2 knights, 2 bishops.
King and a queen.
King and a queen.
Then 8 pawns.
18, yeah, and 8 pawns. So that's 16. 16 times 2 is 32. All right. End of round 3. We have Rawdoggers with 2. Hey. Sorry.
Mark, get out of here. Get out of here with your bullshit.
Rawdoggers with 2 and High and Mighty with 1. We have my co-host joining us now.
Hey, bud.
Oh. He's
hey, buddy. Hey, bud.
Okay. Round 4. Okay, 2-1, Rawdoggers in first. Round 4 is places around the world.
Stop it. Sorry.
Meg, you can do it in the category if you want.
Whip them.
Okay, anyone want to use anything for this? No. Okay, round 4, Rawdoggers. What city is known as the City of Love?
City of Love.
Paris.
Oh.
Paris.
Wait, is this United States
city? City of Love.
Oh.
Paris.
Yeah, let's go with Paris. Final answer.
That's correct.
Yay.
Good job. All right, High and Mighty, what city is known as the city that never sleeps?
New York.
Yeah.
New York City, final.
That's correct.
Thanks.
Nice.
All right, 2-3 at the end of round 4. Moving into round 5, the category is pseudonym, which means fake name.
Ha ha.
Anybody want to use anything? No.
Nope.
Okay. All right, Rawdoggers. What famous pop singer was born with the legal name Robin Fenty?
Robin Fenty.
Rihanna. Final answer.
Didn't even check with the team.
Wow.
Dude.
Good job. I did not know that.
She's answering like Melly.
I love it. All right, High and Mighty.
Oh, shit.
What famous rapper was born with the legal name Curtis Jackson?
50 Cent, final answer.
Wow, hey. Connelly's. Y'all know your pseudonyms. All right, end of round five. We've got Rawdoggers with 4 points and High and Mighty with 3. So moving into the head-to-head round, we'll do first to three. We've got, what order do y'all want to go in Rawdoggers? I'm sorry, the category is top pop singers of 2021.
Okay.
Have y'all done that one? I have another one if so.
No, we're good.
We haven't. Okay. Let's say Noah, me, Izzy.
Okay. And Josh, what order y'all want to go?
Me, Scott, Lance.
Okay.
Pressure.
And then Rawdoggers, y'all go first.
All right. We can go ahead and start.
Yeah, if y'all want head-to-head top pop singers of 2021 according to Billboard, Noah, start us off.
Okay. I'm gonna go with Ed Sheeran.
Josh?
Dang. Billie Eilish?
Allison?
You said female pop singers, right?
Top pop singers.
Oh, okay. Just making sure.
Oh,
shit.
He fell in the seat.
Scott?
Oh, y'all, I don't know pop singers. Oh, fuck. I don't.
Name one.
5 seconds.
I don't know. Kim Petra, I don't know. There.
I guess.
Izzy?
This answer never fails. Justin Bieber, baby.
What?
It failed.
He's not on the top 10, according to Billboard.
No.
I don't know if this is going to count, but the Kid Leroy.
Oh, what the?
Wasn't it Lance's turn?
I think it was my turn.
It was Lance's turn.
Oh, shit.
All right, so that answer's null. And it's back to...
Okay,
my bad.
Nola, but that was one of them.
Wow.
I got excited.
No, it's Noah's turn, Lance. You don't get Bruno.
Wait, I don't. So that's just my round.
Yeah.
Well, shit.
You can do next time. All right, Noah.
What?
I'm going to go with Bruno Mars since Lance already gave it to me.
Oh, no. That just destroyed this thing.
All right. You can go now, Lance. You can go now, Lance.
I'm thinking. I'm so thrown right now, guys.
You got like 5 seconds.
Khalid.
Incorrect. Allison.
The Weeknd.
Ooh.
Great, because that's what I was about to say. Why y'all gotta do this to me?
Mac bit a hole in my leg.
Can't y'all pick some good topics? I don't fucking know. I don't know.
Yeah, 5 seconds, Josh.
I really don't know another one right now.
All right.
Okay. I don't know if anyone said this. Post Malone.
That's a good guess. Both yours have been good guesses. Scott.
Wait, he just went, no?
Josh just went.
No, Justin.
Oh, shoot.
DJ Khaled.
Like, he's a producer.
Bad. Send us home, baby.
Noah.
I'm gonna go with Harry Styles.
Ooh, watermelon sugar.
Oh, that was a good one.
All right, that was it. Good job.
Let's go, baby.
That was tough.
That was
I ruined
tough.
That.
What?
That was a good one.
I said, Lance, it's your turn, but then John.
Yeah, it wasn't on you. I mean, we just botched that.
I jumped the gun.
Oh, my. What's the score?
Don't call it a comeback.
5-3.
We won't.
It's 6-3. That was
we just
double.
Fell apart hard there. It's what?
It's 6-3 because that was double.
Okay.
All right. The answer
okay. Here we go. We're a second half team, high and mighty.
I needed to donate to charity.
Let's go, okay?
The answers to those was Ariana Grande, Billie Eilish, Bruno Mars, Cardi B, Harry Styles, The Kid LAROI, Lil Baby, Megan Thee Stallion, Tyler, the Creator, and Ye, Y-E.
In my head, I went Lil Baby, no hip hop.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking too.
Dang it.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I could punch a little baby right now.
Oh, man.
Okay, moving into the second half. Both y'all still have your phone and friends, surrenders, and double downs. Round 7, the category is NFL. Anyone want to use anything?
Let's double down.
Wait, should we use surrender?
Yeah, we should.
We'll use our surrender.
Okay, so they cannot guess if y'all miss. And then Lance, or Josh, y'all using the double down?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Sounds good. Okay, so Rawdoggers. Rawdoggers, what is the only NFL team to complete a perfect season, meaning that they won all their regular season and postseason
games? Wait, didn't we have this question?
I think we've had this one before, didn't we?
Oh.
Didn't you do this one?
I actually just asked it in an unaired episode.
It's unaired, but...
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, so it's not my fault?
No, it's not. I mean... So,
is this fair game, then? Or... I mean,
do y'all want to call it fair game?
I feel like I told somebody about this.
Well, I mean, if you think about it, I mean, I kind of remember it. I'm not going to lie.
I don't remember what you said, to be honest.
I know what
just let him. Just let him take it. The episode's not out. It's whatever. That's crazy, though.
All right.
That is crazy. No, I mean, this is fair game. I mean, the episode's not live, so.
Okay, I'm
it's sorry. Miami Dolphins.
Sorry, I just lost track. Miami Dolphins?
Yeah
finally.
Allison?
That's correct.
Woo! That's crazy.
What if the other question's the same?
I'm going to quit being friends with y'all and telling y'all anything.
Surely it's not. Let's see. Yeah.
You are our host, Josh.
Don't call it a comeback. We're not calling it a comeback.
Oh, I forgot that was literally the last match y'all were in.
Yeah, the last.
3 days ago.
All right, high and mighty for doubling down. Which team won the first Super Bowl in 1967?
Packers final.
That's correct. Good job. All right, so y'all got 5 there. So it is 5-7. Rawdoggers in first going into round 8. All right, category is favorite sitcom families. Anyone want to use a lifeline?
Should we surrender them or anything? Is this one? No. Oh, hold on.
I think we can hang on. I think we hang on this.
All right.
Y'all
good? We're good. Okay. What was the last name of the leading family in the show, The Cosby Show?
Last name?
Cosby?
I think.
Would it not be Cosby?
Is
it
a trick question?
Isn't it Bill Cosby?
But... I don't know if they use the real last name Cosby.
10 seconds.
It seems like they would, though, right?
Should we say
if they
like
named
William
the Cosby Show?
Yeah.
5.
Just go.
Nene.
Just go Cosby.
Cosby, final answer.
That is incorrect. High and Mighty.
They were the Huxtables.
The Huxtables? Okay.
Yeah.
Final.
That is correct.
Scott, let's go.
That was
big.
Don't call it a comeback.
I was about to phone a friend a second there.
All right. High and Mighty. To tie it up, what was Will Smith's aunt's name in The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air?
Vivian Banks, yeah.
Vivian Banks.
Final. I almost said Smith for a second.
Good job.
I ran those questions by some of my girlfriends, and they were like, you picked two very controversial people, Will Smith and Bill Cosby. All right, so it is tied 7-7. Going into round 9, the category is slogans. Y'all want to use anything?
Slogans.
No.
No?
Do we think about a surrender here?
Yeah. Wait, how many more questions are there?
I did slogans on the last match, too. Let's surrender them. You wanna?
Let's use it this round. Yeah.
All right, we'll surrender.
Just in case.
Yeah. Okay. Yep.
All right. Y'all don't want to double down, Rawdoggers?
No.
Okay. All right, Rawdoggers. What slogan is play, laugh, grow?
Play, laugh, grow.
Would it be like Gerber? Or baby brand.
Yeah, it's Fisher Price.
Fisher Price, final answer.
Fisher Price.
That was good.
That was very good.
Good job on that one.
That was good.
I remember I used to see the commercials and all that when I was younger.
All right, High and Mighty. High and Mighty. What slogan is Breakfast of Champions?
Wheaties,
final.
I thought a lot sooner than I thought you would. That's good. All right. So now it is 8-8, still tied going into round 10. And the category for round 10 is famous fictional streets.
Famous fictional streets.
This could be tough.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all want to use anything? Or... I guess Rawdoggers, y'all have double down left. That's all y'all have.
Okay. I don't want to use anything.
Okay. All right, Rawdoggers. What is the street that is repeatedly mentioned throughout the movie Finding Nemo? Just the street.
Lollyway, like, Sydney, 533.
You just need the street.
Oh. Wallaby Way, Sydney? Or Wallaby Way?
Final.
Yeah, I think that's it.
Yes.
That's correct.
Dude.
Good job. And then, High and Mighty, what is the street name that Freddy Krueger lives? Oh, sorry.
Oh, yeah.
Well, we got you.
Take it back.
What is the street name that Freddy Krueger lives on?
The Elm Street.
Yeah, should be. Elm Street, final answer.
Correct. Good job. All right. 9-9 going into round 11. Oh, it's a close game. Y'all both still have find a friend or phone a friend. And then Rawdoggers, y'all have double down if you want it.
Do we use phone a friend?
No. We didn't use phone a friend.
We have that one too.
Yeah,
so we have phone a friend and...
Which I will, you can't use your phone a friend or any of them in the niche round, which is round 12. So this is the last round if y'all want to use anything.
Okay. Can we use both our double down and our phone a friend?
No.
No. Can't stack
them. You can only use one per one.
Well, what's the category?
The category is acronyms.
Do y'all want to double down for that? I don't want to lose our points.
No, I'd rather have the phone a friend, to be honest.
Okay, we're not gonna do anything right now.
Okay, cool. All right, Rawdoggers. What does the acronym, I pronounce it GIF, some people say GIF, G-I-F, stand for?
Okay, if we don't know the answer, I know a guy.
Really?
I think so.
I think it might be graphic imagery format.
Are you?
Because
sure?
I remember.
You have 15 seconds.
Who asked me?
Should I call Melly?
Are you sure about
I can call Melly.
I think
he'll know
I think
the answer
it's that because
sure.
Okay, I was talking
Melly.
To somebody
call
about
Melly.
It and I looked it
we're
up.
We're calling Melly.
We're calling
Melly.
Y'all are paused at 24 seconds. So if he does not answer, you have 6 seconds to give me an answer.
Come on,
but if not,
Melly.
Go at graphic imagery.
Okay.
Format. Can't see it.
Melly, Melly, Melly.
Come on, Melly. Come on, Melly. 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 Can I give him one more call? Or is that my only call?
I'll allow it. Okay, is that allowed? I don't know. I don't
one
care.
One more ring. Come on.
One more ring. Okay.
Melly.
For Melly.
Melly, please.
Melly.
He is so hopeful.
No!
How much you had a Betty sleeping?
What did you say? Graphic imagery format?
I think. Maybe.
Okay. All right. Final
I'm
answer.
Not sure.
All right. I think it's graphic interchange format.
But is it file or format? Is it format?
Format.
Okay.
I think it's graphic interchange format.
Final. What Scott said.
That is correct.
I was close.
Let's go.
I was so close.
I'm so upset.
All right. High and Mighty, what does the acronym BOGO stand for?
Buy one, get one.
Buy one, get one. Final.
Buy one, get one.
Good job. All right. Well, that puts y'all, High and Mighty is up 11-9 going into round 12, which is y'all's niche round. You cannot use any of your lifelines anymore. So we will start with Rawdoggers. Okay, Rawdoggers, y'all gave the categories of Fortnite, Call of Duty, and Mac Miller. And High and Mighty chose Mac Miller for y'all. Okay. Prefacing this, I don't know much about him, so we'll see if this is a... All right, Mac Miller served as a recorder producer for various artists, including himself, under what pseudonym? Which, as we learned earlier, is fake name.
Is it our question? It's our question, right?
Yeah, it's Rawdoggers. Yeah.
Larry Fisherman. Final answer.
Was
damn.
That our question?
No, that's pretty solid.
Not for me.
No, that's a good.
I just know.
That's a solid question.
I know
I wouldn't
know
that too, so watch your back.
I wouldn't have known.
That's pretty interesting, though. He recorded himself. Okay. And then High and Mighty. If you get this, you win. If you miss it and they don't steal it, then it's a tie. So let's just make one of these two things happen. All right. High and Mighty, y'all gave the categories of NFL, The Office, and Cosmic Anomalies, and Rawdoggers chose The Office. Thank God. I was like, I'm going to have to look up this Cosmic Anomaly thing. Okay, High and Mighty. In the season 5 opener, Weight Loss, Pam goes to art school. What is the name of the receptionist that fills in for Pam while she is at Pratt?
Lance, you know who it is? Like, you know what she looks like? I don't want to talk about it for the other team. Before
no,
Aaron.
I mean, It's a different.
Hang on.
It's a random person, like for one episode.
I can't remember her name.
Need an answer.
All right. Okay, so it was like some old lady, wasn't it? It was like an older lady.
I felt like it was Aaron. I really thought it was Aaron.
No, because she came in the later episodes. I remember.
No,
she
there was a blonde girl that did it, I'm pretty sure.
5 seconds.
I feel like it's
Linda or something.
Need an answer.
Linda, final answer.
No!
Incorrect. The answer was Ronnie. Risa Ronnie. Remember, she was that old woman?
Oh, Risa Ronnie.
Aaron like had that from Microsoft Paper Company.
Yeah.
I knew exactly what she looked like. Cannot remember that name.
So it is tied 11 to 11.
Oh, there's another...
Has this happened before?
No, but I think we should do a head-to-head for the win. Because remember, didn't we? Or you're just going to have to come up with one on the fly, and I can cut it down.
I also do have some trivia cards right in front of me for, like, a game that I could just pick from. So what do y'all want to do, the head-to-head or just me pick some two trivias out of this?
I'm down for whatever.
Faster with the trivias.
Do what?
Pull the cards.
This is it. I mean, this determines who wins this match of trivia. So yeah, let's do a card.
Okay. Okay, there's one. And then sorry, I'm trying to look at some that might be equal.
So we're doing the same thing where we can steal it too? Or is it just okay?
Can we double down as well?
So this is overtime. This is the first round of overtime.
First overtime round. Okay. So
wow.
I have two cards. Let's see. Josh picks the order. So Allison, I have one card in my right hand and one in my left. Pick which one you want me to read for y'all.
Left.
Left. Okay. Get my timer. Alrighty.
Holy hell.
Rawdoggers. How many ribs do humans have?
Wait, let me count.
Is it 14?
Well,
12?
Don't females like have an extra rib, though?
An extra rib?
No, that's from the Bible.
Yeah, because y'all took one of ours.
Stop. Just a joke. You want to say 14?
Just a joke, guys. Just
like
a joke.
12 or 14.
Biblical.
I don't
know. Let's go 14.
I think it's 24.
Wait, are you sure?
I feel like that's too many.
No.
Need an answer.
I'm counting.
Say
24.
Say 24. Say 24. 14.
Final answer.
24.
Incorrect. High and mighty for the steal. How many ribs do humans have?
Do we trust Noah and try to burn him?
I mean, we could. My thought was 16, 8 on each side.
Scott, any guesses?
12 seems like quite a bit of bones.
Okay, let's go 16. Final.
The answer was 24.
We should have did it. We should have burned him.
He burned you on the burn on Mars. You could have got him back.
I thought that was too much.
I guess you have 12 on each side, and then 24.
I guess.
Dang.
All right, high and mighty for the win. What color is the letter E in the Google logo?
Oh.
Looking at more questions.
Is the E blue?
15 seconds.
Is it Roy G. Biv? Like, is it violet? Is it in the same amount of letters? Like red?
G-O-O-V-L-E.
You got 5 seconds.
Let's go blue. Final.
What'd you do?
Blue.
Incorrect. Rawdoggers. What color
I know
is
it.
E in the Google symbol?
It's
what
red.
Is it?
It's red. I'm thinking red.
Red.
It's red.
Okay, red.
That's it!
say yes, someone has to close their browser.
Good job. Good job, everybody.
Oh, shenanigans.
That was amazing. Okay, so our final score is...
We're coming for the season, baby.
Raw Dogs with 12 against High and Mighty with 11. Yeah!
Dude. Oh, my God.
Good job, everybody. Love you, Sid. Good job.
The most talked about team this season after they air. Holy shit.
Yay!
Oh, quit shaking our baby.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, he kind of likes it, it looks
What's up, buddy?
Hi, everybody.
Oh, hey.
Oh. Bubby's sad because he pop lost.
Fortnite.
Yeah, that was a whirlwind of emotions. I'm just going to say that. Up and down. I mean, the most, roller coaster ride of a game I've had this season.
I think
Holy
that was one
shit.
Of the best games played that have been.
Hey, I never said the answer before the team stole it. That was a. I did that twice last time I hosted. I was like, nope, the answer's this.
Yeah.
So, counted as a win. Oh. That was a good game, though. Good job, everybody.
All right. Just about all. Great game.
We're coming for your next this season.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, my God.
Well.
All right.
It was fun.
All right.
Merch right. coming y'all. Soon.
All right, guys.
Bye,
love
guys.
You.
Bye.
Bye.
Yes, sir.
See you.
Pull up the single turn up. Yeah. Pull up the single turn up.